Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Morphology of Flowering Plants. In that, we are studying topic structure of a fruit. We all have eaten fruit every day and most of our life. But do we know that there are certain parts present in fruit? For example, the outer covering, the inner covering, the seed. Today we'll be studying what is the detailed structure of a fruit and what part does it consist of. Fruit. Fruit is basically formed after the process of fertilization. The process of fertilization is nothing but when pollen grains, that is the male gamete, meets the egg, the female gamete. And finally, after that process, fertilization occurs. So fruit is basically a matured, or you can say a ripened ovary formed after fertilization. The structure of the fruit basically consists of two parts. One is the seed part from which a plant can be grown. And another part is basically the fruit wall, or you can say the outer covering, or in bio language we can say the pericarp. Inside fruit, you can say three different layers, or you can say pericarp is basically divided into three different layers. Epicarp, mesocarp and endocarp, and these are the inner layers of the fruit, and inside these inner layers the seed is present. The outer covering of the fruit, or you can say the pericarp, is basically the protective covering of the fruit. It protects the fruit during wear and tear, during climatic condition change, etc. It is made up of cellulose and other polysaccharide materials. Inside seed there will be cotyledons. Now for example, mango is a dicot plant. When I say dicot, it is made up of two different parts. Your rice is a monocot plant. It is one cotyledon. Whereas all your dal or leguminous plants are basically dicots. Mango is a fruit which is termed as true fruit. When I say true fruit, during the process of fertilization, if there is pollen grains matched or mixed or fertilized with the egg of a same flower, or you can say one gamete or one flower, then it's called as true fruit. Basically, true fruits develop from ovary, or you can say only the process of fertilization has gained the development of their fruit. Whereas the fruit of jackfruit, during jackfruit development, there is not only ovary taking part in the process of formation of jackfruit, even the thalamus, the leaf of the jackfruit, is from the thalamus, the down part of the flower. So there is ovary and something else that is taking part in jackfruit formation, which is false fruit. Whereas mango is a true fruit because only ovary takes part in its formation, and later the seed will help to form the plant. Structure of a fruit. Now basically, a fruit is nothing but a matured or a ripened ovary formed after the process of fertilization, or after the gametes have basically fused. Typical fruit has basically two important parts. One is the seed part from which a plant will be grown, and another is the fruit wall, or you can say the pericarp wall, or the outermost layer of the fruit. In case of mango, it will be the greenish outer covering of the mango before it has matured, and after it has matured, it will be the yellow covering. Pericarp is basically divided into three different structures or three different parts. The outer covering, which is called as the exocarp or epicarp. Then there is the middle covering, which is called as the mesocarp, which is the innermost layer, and it has varying thickness. In the case of mango, the thickness of mesocarp is little more because this is the fleshy part which we actually consume. And the last part is endocarp, the inner layer beside which the seed will be present or situated. This is a structure of a mango fruit showing its various structures. Now this is called as epicarp, the outermost layer, or you can see the green covering layer. In the case of other fruits, for example jackfruit, epicarp will be nothing but the scaly or the outer surface of the fruit. Mesocarp is actually the fleshy layer which we actually consume whenever you're eating a mango fruit. Endocarp is nothing but the cotyledonous region. We all know that the seed of the mango whenever we eat is thick. That is not actually the seed of the mango. That is the cotyledon, or you can say the embryo that protects the mango. And inside this cotyledon or embryo, there is the seed of the mango, which is dicot, or consists of two cotyledons. So this is, in short, the structure of mango. Together, they form pericarp, or all the layers of the fruit. Students, in this part of the chapter, what we have seen is the structure of mango, its various layers, and which is the layer which we actually consume in certain food. We have also seen that mango is a true fruit that develops from just ovary and the various parts present inside mango. I hope you all are clear about this concept of the structure of a fruit. Thank you.